We actually, my mom and dad, for all the time I camped with them, we had a pop-up Apache trailer, and I think it was an Apache Buffalo, made in Lapeer, Michigan, the kind that sort of the tents kind of pop up, and that's why I traveled all over America in those as a kid. And later, my mom and dad did get a kind of custom van, but nothing like what John and Ella have. So,
So, last question. Tell us about the tiki bars of Detroit.
okay. Well, that's yet another one of my interests. I've just been sort of fascinated with tiki culture for a long time, the music and just that whole notion of, and I mean, a lot of that came about in the 50s when soldiers were coming back from World War II after the war, and they were kind of interested in South, but they were in the South Pacific, and that play, South Pacific, was popular, and then later Hawaii became the 50th state, and people just became fascinated with, at a time that's thought of as fairly repressed and kind of, so here was this kind of subculture where you could be, you could drink a lot, and the women wore grass skirts and coconut bras, and there was this fascination with the taboo, and native culture and pagan rituals, and a whole culture grew out of that, including the bars. And so it was so and then it faded in the 70s, but people rediscovered it like in the 80s, and they continue to rediscover it, the music and the bars. But unfortunately, a lot of the bars have been knocked down, and at this point, all of them have been knocked down in Detroit. But I just wanted to write about it, and I wanted to write a story for a Detroit Noir. And that was really it. Just what I thought, maybe this is the time for the tiki story. And it wasn't particularly noir, but I knew they had a fairly loose interpretation of it. And so it and so that story was kind of born out of all my interest in tiki culture and my tiki mug collection. So it continues to be a source of fascination for me, and unfortunately, Detroit just lost its last tiki bar. The Chin Tiki was knocked down, like in the story, and made into a parking lot. So it's a shame, but there are other parts of the country that have their tiki culture, and I just think there's something weird and evocative about that whole era, and so it's just one of my personal obsessions.
Okay, I thought of one more last question.
It's okay.
All right. So what is your hope for Detroit? Being a Detroiter, kind of, I mean, yeah, you are a Detroiter. So what is your hope for Detroit?
Well, I hope I hope that we can figure out some new ways to make things work, and it's not like I'm any expert on any of this. I don't, but I feel like I'm hoping that maybe in some ways, it feels like in a strange way that these horrible economic times, I'm noticing a lot of art happening and music happening and writing happening in not just Detroit, but the whole area. And when I speak for, it's not like I'm some sort of urban guy, I live in Ferndale, just outside of Detroit, but it seems like there's so much creative talent going on there now, and I feel like, and it's exciting with the film industry, so I feel like some of that has a new, might be hopefully a kind of new direction for the area, and an appreciation of, of like a lot of the creative work that comes out of the area, and a lot of the creative people, because I know so many. I get together at a local watering hole with my friends, and I look down the table, and it's like poet, writer, artist, performance artist, DJ, musician, musician, and there's so much talent there, and so I personally, I would love to see some of that become more appreciated with the rest of the world, and in the rest of the state, and so that's just my own little personal hope and wish for the area.
Thanks for coming to the line.